Yeah, Kevin is there. Kevin is in the left corner.
Just for Kevin.
Okay.
And for the internet.
Thank you all for showing up in such large numbers. Our next seminar speaker is Will Ungenent, who is from the Netherlands. Will has transformed a Data East Star Wars game basically into the same game with a completely different look. So the software is the same as the original game, but the playfield is completely new, all the artwork is new, and Will is going to talk about that today. It's not the first time that you did a project like this. I think 2 years ago you showed Medieval Castle.
Yep, it's all later, but later on.
Okay, I won't take anything away from you.
No.
Please give it up for Will Ungenent.
Yeah. Hello. Good afternoon. Welcome to the Dutch Pinball Open Expo 2017. My name is Will Ungenent. I try to do it in English. It's very bad. Jonathan is much better than me. So let's give it a try. Yeah, something about myself. I'm 54. Yeah, 54. Oh, wow. 45 sounds better. And yes, I'm an old school member from the Dutch Pinball Association. And I'm old repair guy. And I buy machines and collect them. Used to have. And if you are 20 years further, you want to do something else. And I want to buy build a pinball machine. So I did it before, and I want to tell something about it. What do I say? Okay, you mind the next picture, please? Okay, this is how I work. Gaat niet voor de video natuurlijk. Okay. It's better. Okay. Well, if I started taking an old play field, I need it pure for the wood. Too hard? Zei die antwoord? Vind je te hard, Dex?
Ja.
Okay. Wil je dopjes hebben? Ik heb een paar oordopjes bij. Zeg je. I take an old play field, only for the size of the wood, and I put some sheets A4 papers on it, and I take one piece of metal and I bend it, and then when it's correct I drill a hole and put it in and take a mark and I'll go on, and in 2 days I completed this game. Ooh, I'm very nervous. Okay, after that that's the other picture. Yes, and this is the first try. This is the second day. If you look close, you see some new sheets are for. You don't have to start all over again. You put a blank paper on it, you try again. And when you're ready, now, next picture, please.
Hold on, if I may ask a question. Yeah? You said you did this in 2 days.
Yes.
That means you got the layout done in
two
days.
Yes, yes.
It's not like you built a complete machine in 2 days.
No. This was the Spider-Man ramp, and this is for the slam ramp, no, the lift ramp for No Good Golfers. I had no measures, so I have to order them in America, so I guessed the size a little bit. And I needed a bigger Death Star. That's the original, and that's a LED lamp from the internet. Star Wars, you can find everything you want, so I needed a bigger Death Star, so this is. Now we go to the next, and then get the right picture. Yes. Who? Even wat jullie zeggen.
Will.
Yeah.
Slow you down a little bit. Can I ask you a question?
Yes, of course. Yeah.
Hold on.
When we go back to the first slide.
Yeah.
You need it harder. Okay. The first slide.
Yeah.
How did you decide which features you would want to play?
That's a good question. Yes, that is because the data is the Star Wars from 92. It has all the events, so I know the events, so I have to look what I can do. So I want to tell you, yes, okay, do the next picture. And the next, yes. Yes. So I first want to tell you how it's made. After I made the other picture with the pen, my wife took a picture with her phone from the playfield for the other picture. And we put it in Photoshop and we measured some measurements, and we stretch it so that the proportions were right. It sounds stupid if you make a you stand here, you put it on the floor, and you just, oh, photo. You put it in the computer, so it doesn't fit. So we stretch it, and we measured all the measurements when they were okay, and then we made a computer version of it. Yeah.
How did you decide, I think on the left side, you have Ghostbusters
yes. stuff? Yes, and when this was ready, I ordered the ramp from Spider-Man and the slam ramp. Well, and I hope the ramp is so wide and this is space enough. So I looked at, well, what can I use? Now, I saw Ghostbusters, I think, hey, that's a nice. It's not the same, I not copy it, I know the idea. It's a different place, a different shape. But I want to use the idea from loop. The original data has the loop to the R2, and you go to the bumpers, very heavy shot, takes a longer time. So I did it here, boom, up, round, ready. And you can go. So the machine is very fast. And this, I printed in real size. And then I take a piece of wood, next picture, please. I put it on and I drill all the holes. So you get a play field. And because the paper version is in the computer, my wife can start to work on the graphics. Mm-hmm. And then, yeah, you get much faster. The total build was 5 months from designing to playable. Even kijken.
Well.
Yeah? Yes, with the hand, I throw balls.
Right.
If my design is ready, I put all the metal on it and I throw balls, throw balls, throw balls.
Right,
yes, and then, yeah, it works for 99%. So a few things doesn't work, it's always, this one, it worked, all, but the medieval castle, it doesn't work. The bumpers are not in the right place, sometimes it will, the ball falls between them and it goes down. So that's why you may want to make a whitewood, but yeah, I want to make one, so I change it later. Okay, the playfield. Yes, I use a lot of round holes. I can't drill square holes, so I like round insert. As I have made a few by hand, it's a pain in the ass, they are. So I don't want to use square. And the problem is with this, with the word Star Wars, if you want to make squares, it's not enough wood. And it breaks and you have to start over. So I'll show you later, I put an extra sticker on it, a copy. And I put it on the alignments and I cut it out. And then the real sticker goes over, so you have a good masking from the other sides. And then you see alleen the letters, no, you don't see the insert. Okay, what's next? Even kijken. Yeah, next picture, please. Okay, it is with the inset. And some idea with the kicker, I have to work it out. You see the line where the ramps come into. So it's, well, it was working nicely. I had a problem with the inserts. And the problem was I can't get inserts here in Holland. So I have to buy them from everywhere else. So I want all white and some red. I didn't get them, so I have taken blue. That's not a good idea. It's better to take it white and then put the blue light on it. It's just brighter. But it's okay. Later on we have it over, we will talk about the graphics. Even kijken, what's next? Yes?
What type of blue?
Oh, wood glue, watertight wood glue, and because I have a special procedure to make the playfield, I invented it. You don't have to make it smooth. Put the insert in, piece of wood, and bang, hammer it in. Make sure that the insert does not fit in the playfield, because the insert has some.
Conical.
Huh? Zeg maar. Hey, dat is niet de bedoeling. Yes, cone shaped. The inserts are cone shaped. So if your wood drill then it's loose. So I take one bigger and I take a little piece off and I make some tests. And the last millimeter, you have to bang it in with a hammer. And then it's okay. And then it looks like this. I put some extra wood on it so it stays straight. Or it. Yeah? Any questions?
Yeah. Did you have to sand it before you continue?
No. I sand it the instant before, there are numbers on it. So I scratch them off, and then hammer it in. And the places go to a little bit this or something, some higher, lower, doesn't matter because I use glass epoxy later. I put a sticker on it, I tell you so. So I put some extra black paint on it, three layers, it's very rough, doesn't matter, leave it. Next picture. Yeah. Now here you see the white wood, not playable, only by hand. And if I have to adjust something, I drill a new hole and make it, I close it up. And I have to say, I haven't drilled one hole the wrong way. I didn't make any, I call it. Yeah. Yes, I didn't have no mistakes. What I have to drill again. Okay. Oh, you see? Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, you see the Spider-Man ramp? You can't see it on the picture, but the Spider-Man ramp I put it lower and I tilted it to the left, so I need the extra shot, but because the Spider-Man has the loop and the Doc Ock and then the ramp. I needed the extra shot for the kickback, so I tilted it a little bit. And you can see it fits in my design and then also this. Yeah, it's going very easy.
How many shots do you have now?
No, you can count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, I don't count this. 6, 7, 8, 9. Targets I don't count. A good machine has always, in my mind, 7 to 9 shots. Is it a 6 shots? All the machines who has 6 shots are always a mistake. Look at all the machines that are hit. They don't have 6 shots. Okay, next. Yes, wow. She didn't like that I put her photo on it. Yes, it's a private picture. This is my wife, Bridget. She makes all the graphics for me. And sometimes I want something I don't get. And sometimes she makes something I don't want. So then we get a lot of argue. But yes, she's making all the graphics for me. It's more Photoshop based. She can draw herself, but it looks more like a painting. It's not usable for a pinball machine. But yes, that's what she do. We go later on. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Next, I wanted to tell something about Bridget. Now here's the medieval castle. There's a picture from. Yeah, it's a totally different style than medieval than Star Wars. Next picture. Yes. Kijk. We did a reskin for my friend Aunt, who's sitting there. And that's in high speed, The Getaway. And my wife makes a new reskin from the cabinet and the back glass. Next picture, please. Yeah, here you can see the machine. So everything is new, but instead of the play field, it's the same. So, yeah, you like it or you don't like it. It's not for sale, it's only for personal use. You hear that? Well, what's his name from the Williams, who has all the rights?
Rick.
Yes, Rick. Rick is only for home use. Okay, next one, please.
Also for the donut shop sticker?
Yes, all the stickers are on one, I don't care. The problem is, if you go to the printer, you have to pay and then you get a print. So if I have to order one sticker, it's the same price almost as the complete machine. It's very, where I can, if someone wants to order it, I can't, but it's home use, you know. As he has a spare one, maybe you want to give it to him. next one, please. Yes, the Pirates of the Caribbean. Yeah, my friend lives around the corner and we have a lot of machines and we play some pinball and then we drink a bottle of booze and go, yeah. And, and he has a translated all punched holes in it. It's, So I don't know, it's old or something. So I made my wife made a new one. Okay. So this and he has some lights on behind the ship, flashlights, so everything flashes and yeah, it looks really nice. Okay, next one. Is that the next one? Okay. Now this is Star Wars. Yeah, it's Star Wars. Yes, Darth Vader, and we don't want to put any real characters on the playfield. More like the Emperor is not a human, so we don't like humans on the playfield. They only use these ones. And there's some mistake I made. Somebody say, "Well, yeah, you give it a name." I say, "Yeah, that's great. That's the one." Yeah, I'm stupid, but that's hard too. Yes. I thought it was the first one that blew up, and that's still working. Now they build a new one. And that's so I have to call it Death Star 2 or Death Star Assault. It's maybe a better name. So maybe I make a new translate and so I give it to someone and put it on the wall. Okay, next one.
Hold on. So I haven't seen the game yet, but I assume that the square in the middle is for an LCD.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yes. That's an LCD. It has a small video player from China. It's a little box that starts on its own. And you can put it out and you put it on, it goes on. So you don't have to switch everything on. You put it in and you put the machine on, it's starting up. And it goes out when you put it out. Right. It's the machine burns out, the video is still playing. It's,
right. So basically there's a sort of video loop.
Yes.
Interactive with gameplay.
No, it is pure and screensaver.
Right.
So I call it. My wife had made some 3D animations by hand, but she's very picky, saying she didn't like it. So we put the movie in. Only shots from space. No actors, no guys, only space movies.
Okay.
Even kijken. Where are we? Okay. Yes. 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 Play with sticker. Okay. Let's put it on a little bit. Now, when the playfield was ready, five pictures back, the inserts, I put on the sticker. Yes. It is a copy from the paper version. Yes. So it fits everything. You put it on. It's a little bit hobbly. You can see that there. It doesn't matter. Take an old iron solder iron and burn out all the holes. Because if you put epoxy on it, you can't see where the holes are. So when it's ready and everything fits, I do an extra fit that to make sure that I don't forget to burn out the hole and I can't put the iron in. So when it's ready, next picture. Oh yeah, this is my own homemade way to make your playfield look like a real one. Now you know the other steps. When you're ready to this, make sure that is completely flat, all the holes are open. Take a can of glass epoxy. I use 50-50, not 60-40, it's too hard. I use 50-50. Toss it over, four times too much. Oh, everything. Make sure that it can drip off. Leave it for 3 days. Oh, sorry, I forget something. When you put it on, take a torch. And then warm it, don't burn it. So warm it in the middle and you see the air pumps out. En doe zo. Ready. Everything ready. Leave it for 3 days. And your playfield looks like this. Later on, I put a Milo on it, a sticker. And this time I do it in front of before I. We have to cut out new models. Very tricky. So I put it on in front of building up the machine. And then you get a playfield that looks like a real one. And I think the cost of the playfield, the insert, the sticker is the sticker is 40 euros. The epoxy hard is 40 euros. The playfield 10 euros. The insert 30 euros. I think the complete playfield can cost you about 125 euros. I design it in 2 days and I make the playfield in 1 week. So you can make at home a real pinball machine that looks like real and it doesn't cost so much.
And you still have to wire it and make sure that
hey, if you make a good design, yeah, I know.
I mean, you have to use every switch that the original game uses.
Yeah, you have to know where everything how it works. I tell you later. I want to tell you something about it. Okay, the next. Yeah, Okay. Now you can say I used the NGV, No Good Golfers lift ramp. I say slam ramp. And you see here, I had some extra space. Yeah. Dus hey, it fits. I tried it and it fit. And I cut off the old Star Wars ramp and I cut it here and the bend was like this and I put it up there and here's a hole for the
twirl in it. Yeah.
Yes. Says I have to slow down the ball a little bit before it goes to Costello. So and normally the dead star is here and then you hit the target and then it goes down. You can in and you start multiball. In my version, you have the kickback and that it calls deflective shield now and when it's red, then the dead star opens for multiball. And when the mode is down, you are the normal all modes. So it fits now. You have an extra shot, and it works. It looks like it looks a little bit nicer, I think. Next, yeah, you see the Spider-Man ramp. Now the same again. I had some spare room, so and you see here at this the normal skim that's in. In the back box and now it's lower and tilted. Yeah, it works. Why want to make a new ramp? You have to make a mold for clay. Your €500 before it works, and then you have to find out if it works. Oh, buy Steve's ramp, it's much better. Okay, next please. Yeah, yay, the wiring. Yeah, bottle of booze. This is the sound studio here. Here's the computer with all the sound studio equipment. Here's sitting my wife. Yeah, and I put it on the dinner table. We have to eat 3 days Chinese. We're gonna have to do. And you can see. And I use the Star Wars as a donor, but there were some troubles because Dati's has all the wirings in one loom. And then they cut it off and you solder it on. And where you miss games, you can strip it. You have a power loom, a light loom, a switch loom, and you start by layers. But Dati's has all crunched to one piece with almost the same colors and everything. So I cut everything off. The bumpers are here, you have to go down. I cut everything away. And I start all over. And in 2 days it was finished. And when I put the machine on, everything was working without one switch or wire, what's one. I never blew up a machine.
You did not use the original wire?
Yes, it is original, but the only thing what fits are the flippers and the flipper returns. Yeah, because that is Star Wars. So and the drop targets are different, the bumpers are different, the Death Star is different, nothing fits. I have to cut everything off.
So you mean you had to sort of extend the wires to make sure that they could work?
Yeah, but what I do, I cut everything off and then I solder all the wires first together. And I got a new wires, and then I go. That's easy.
Okay.
Yeah, I cut everything off and I solder it together. Yes, and then go. Yes.
Can I ask something?
Yeah.
How did you program all the stuff? You have one thing with all the elements.
Yeah.
And you have to program it.
No, nothing. It's a Dati's. It's a 92 Dati's machine. I used the hardware and the software. Yeah, you have to know the events. You have to know that the Death Star switch, target, and it goes open. Next switch is multi-ball, and then as you didn't see the second switch, the third switch is.
So you don't have to measure it up
No, I want to put something extra in, so I have to make some extra things. So what I said, the Death Star is different from the target now, so you have to hit it and it kicks back. I use the fourth bumper to power it. And a double switch, one is a switch from the bumper to activate, and the switch from the Death Star is beneath, and it puts two switches down, so it's...
Okay,
yeah,
it's recognition, all the stuff.
Yes.
Okay.
And I used the original motor, and it goes now, it goes very slow, it works. Next, please. Just kidding. Okay, here you can see the same playfield. Almost ready. I couldn't use one lamp board. That's I can throw them all away. And I bought all new fittings. How is that fittings? Lamp fittings. Lamp holders. Yeah, that sounds much better. Yeah. Yes. Dus I put all lamp holders in. You can see it's all old stuff. You see some gray there. It's a beetje it looks old. It was a very old, bad machine. Okay, next please.
I just want to know, was that a machine you bought from me?
No, I sold it for 600 euros and now I have to pay 1500 euros. I sold it for 700 guilders. And I have to pay 1500 euros, that's four times. Hey, you see this, the cabinet? It's very dusty. You get some the holes from the logs and the old legs, right? You know, you sand it down and a beetje, how do you call it, plumber?
Plaster.
Yeah, it's plaster, some plaster. Polyester plaster to make it smooth. And I don't like all the Latin colors, yellow, blue, so I paint it. Next picture? Black.
Yeah,
yeah, the sticker doesn't shine through. Well, you can make it every color, doesn't work, but doesn't matter. Next, please. Now you can see it's built on the attic. Eh? I had a small room. It was two meters by 150, and it was like this. So I was standing so for the machine, yeah? And I made the machine. And now I have an own room. My son is going out of the house. He has a nice girl. They buy our house. I've got his room. I have two machines, some gambling machines, a fridge for the booze for my friend of mine. So,
are you saying you're working on something?
Building
number? No, not yet. I have some ideas for a fun house. I have a stupid idea. You may know it. I want to put an extra playfield in it, and I want to put a camera on it. So, if in the back box, you see there, and the display of someone holding a sign, and that is your display, a little bit scheef, hoe zeg je dat?
Tilted.
A little tilted. And if you go playing, you can see the camera, what you're doing on the, maybe there's some slowdown, I don't know. Dus you can build it in the bottom of the, in the cabinet, as an extra feature. So I want to make a fun house with four floors. Next. Okay. The graphics. Okay. Yeah, Star Wars, you can find a lot of pictures. I have to say, I only make one machine. I don't want to have any troubles with Disney. It's not for sale. It's my machine. And it's going home and on the attic. That's the other one. The picture is... The playfield was 85 megapixels. Megapixels. 85. And the total for Photoshop working space for only the playfield was 1.2 gig. And the printing size was 65 MBs. Right. It's a resolution of, I don't know, 15,000 by 7,000 or so.
In 300 dpi.
300, yes, a good question, 300 dpi. And then, yeah, the letters he makes themselves with Photoshop and some lines. And yes, he's very clever too. Do things with Photoshop. So you made two things by yourself. That was the X-Wing between the flippers and the Millennium Falcon by the hyperspace. They didn't stand in the right angle, so you makes themselves in a 3D computer program. Dus, well, nothing is hand-drawn. Kevin, don't worry. It's all from the internet. Next, please. Yeah. Yeah, some sky. Yeah, but there are some flaws in it. See, a big Star Wars fan who see what's the problem? I give you a hint. The left picture. What is wrong? Yeah, the silver leg is his right leg. It has to be his left leg. I said I put it on the left side on the cabinet. She tilted the picture. Now it's the left side. And it's silver plus on the right. Yeah. So, okay, next one. Okay, this is the back box. Yeah, it looks like it's short, but yeah, you can do a lot of it. Photoshop. She made the lightning, the fire. She all renders herself. It's the same with the high speed trans light. You see some lights in the air. So you have a filter and they put it on off. Or in real time, you see it day and night. And you see the flares from the lantern poles on the way. On the road, so she can do a lot of tricks. Okay, next please. Okay, the plastics. Yeah, Okay, I made everything by hand. I have a special scissor. It's made from Macralon, from Bayer. It's 2 millimeters and you can bend it, hammer it, and not, does never break. Yeah? And you can cut it with a scissor. And when it's ready, then I take it along a grindstone or something, or you call that something, a slice stone?
Yeah.
A grindstone, and then ready. So one day it's all ready. It's white paper, plastic on it to protect them. And you see this, what I want to cut out. And later on, the sticker is the same sticker as the play feed, only I let it print it upside down on and then let it put a white layer over it. No gloss layer, but a white layer. Yes? Vinyl. It's online, by an online shop, and the sheets are 35 euros a piece, and the bigger ones, the cabinet is 40, I think. So you can, if you can make something, then it's cheaper. The printing is not the problem. And then you can see where the lines are. That I cut later. I put it on the one sticker, so, and then I cut it with a mesh and I pull. Peeled it off, so we get some holes.
Yeah.
That sounds better. Okay. Now you can see I used also the Star Wars ramp. I cut it off, and this is the other ramp. I welded together with some tricks. It works. Yeah. Okay. The floors are out. Next, please. Oh yeah, the lightning. Well, I work with lights and sound on my work and. Yeah, I use LEDs, but I have not some good picture in the next one. Can you switch one further? Yes, and one back. Okay. Now you see yellow. These are the same lights. Alleen if you use some other lights on the playfield, you get some tegenlicht. Hoe heet dat?
Counterlight.
Yes, counterlight. Okay, if you have a Spider-Man, all my inserts are printed on the sticker. Eh? You don't see the inserts. Oh, the verlengsflares from the inserts are on the sticker. It looks real, but it's fake. Yes, all the glitters from the lenses are in the sticker printed. And if you, dus I use only white, high gloss, cold white. Yes. And if you use warm spots, you get other inserts. So if you have a Spider-Man with real inserts and you want LED lights, and the white inserts are very shiny. If you put some LED on the machine, then it look a little bit dark, and you can see all the graphics. You don't see all of that. So
not too in your face.
Yes, not in your face. That's, I think they have to do some more. Stern uses LEDs, but if they put a few LEDs on in the right places, in plaats van bulbs, then you can play my machines in the dark. You don't need light. If you don't like it, you can use everything in warm white if you want. Some old guys with electromechanical machine don't like the cold LEDs, they want the warmth. But you have warmer LEDs that look like the original. I prefer for Star Wars cold because it's blue space. I have to see where I'm next, please. Is this the last one?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, here you can see the machine finished almost. Only R2 is left. On the left side isn't there. Cliffy protectors.
Yeah.
Yes, Cliffy made two scoop holes for me, especially to fit in my machine.
You also did a custom apron.
No, it is the original apron. I put two pieces, two posts on it, and I make a plastic one. I put a sticker on it and some LED strips, and I have a dimmer in the machine to put it high or low. It is not on the machine; it's on 220. I don't want to stress out the internal 12 volt.
Right. So, and then the question remains: how does it play?
Much better than MC. It's very fast, and the data is very slow software, and not so much, because I split the Death Star. It's fun, but you go up, it goes down. It's faster down than Spider-Man, and the ramp is very good. It's not so easy to shoot at, but the new software 1.7 you can get an extra ball, A2Ms in eMemory. So if you want to play it all the RAMs, you get an extra ball. And you have a machine that calls multi-millions. You know, it's an X-ring and a BAM with them. Normally you have all the stand-up targets here and you can hit something, but now if the mode starts, you have to shoot here, kabang, 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 million. So it has some extra things, some fun. Yeah, still is the old Davies machine, there are no rules. Yeah, a few modes and that's it. But it's very fast, and I put some extra post here. Normally it's plastic and that stops, and I put always an extra post here, so the ball time is very long. You can let it play, it doesn't matter. Well, why play at home 100 balls in 20 games? Why not 20 games with 10 balls? Yeah, you know what I mean. So yeah, it's, if you can play a little bit, it's very fun to play. No, there's no drain monster.
The seminar prior to yours,
yeah.
We had the Pin Sound guy talking.
Good question.
About,
yes.
The Pin Sound board, which is actually compatible with Data East games. Mm-hmm. So my question would you be interested or
yes.
looking into changing the sound
yeah.
in the game?
Yes, my wife is already busy with it. We have our own sound studio. We want to make our own calls. We have voice processors, everything. So yes, no, it says Death Star, shoot the Death Star, or Death Star down, or make a call. I can make my own calls. I use the Pin Sound. Sound is good. The music is in, so I don't have to change everything. But I want to make some custom call outs. So yes, we write it over. And then, but it's a lot of work. It's I think it's almost 6-7 months work.
Right. Okay. So in total, because you were telling us that the design of the playfield took you like 2 days,
yes.
and the drilling of the playfield was a week or so. So how long did it take you in total?
I started in January after the holidays. I heard that Steve probably make a Star Wars, and I wanted to make a Star Wars. I don't want to make it from later. Then, you look at Steve and you make it. I want to make my own machine before Stern comes. And I hope that they use something. The same with Games of Thrones. My machine was 6 months earlier, and then came Steve, and it looks like Steve's Games of Thrones. And I can explain that. I'm a great fan of Steve, and I was thinking, if Steve wants to make a new Black Knight, what is he going to do? He wants a normal, modern machine with a lot of shots. No split level where you can't shoot. So that was, I think, I make him a new Black Knight. If you look at Pin Sound, my first was Black Knight. And then I changed it to that movie, the vampire movie. Van Helsing. Yeah, so it's a shitty film, but Van Helsing has The Q, the Vampire Girls, Frankenstein, Dracula. It's a great team to make a pinball machine. So Medieval Castle was originally Van Helsing, and then the werewolves were the trolls, and the castle was another castle with a hit toy that drops down. It was the ice shield from You Go to the Other World. And my wife doesn't want to do the software. Takes a lot of time, she can do it. But I decided I do something what everybody doesn't do. You can make a complete machine, you can make a reskin, or do the same machine with some extra software, and I do a new machine with old software. It's easier, cheaper, and a lot of fun. And you have to be.
Keep you off the streets.
Yeah, keep me off the streets.
I feel like playing it. Is it here?
Yes,
yeah,
it's
on Ring 4.
Yeah, Ring 4. You go to the elevator, you go out left, and there's Medieval Castle and the Star Wars are standing there.
Ring 4.
Yes.
Four. Yes, that's the smallest floor, so it's not difficult to spot. You don't have to circle it three times.
Oh, you can go by the stairs, you go there tomorrow, I think.
So, would you like to do some Q&A?
Yeah, yes, okay.
Any questions from people in the audience, and if so, allow me to get to you with a mic so we have the audio as well for the video. So, any questions?
Nothing?
Not
come on. You have something else, Kevin? You want to ask something?
Would you like to comment?
Have you put an application in at Stern?
No.
I wonder if you had put an application in.
No, Steve saw my machine and what's his name of the original make of John Borg. Saw my machine and he liked it. It was very fun. But yes, I'm in Holland and they live in America, so. And I think Steve is a much better designer than me, than I am. So let's keep it that way.
Any other questions or suggestions?
Okay. No.
Then let's round this up. I want to thank everybody for attending. I'd like a warm hand for Will Achenet for this project.
Thank you. Go upstairs and play. While still working.
So you can play Will's Star Wars at Ring 4. We
elevator left.
There was a difficulty getting it downstairs for the seminar, so we left it up there. We'll be back at 2 o'clock with pinball artist Kevin O'Connor, who's already